words are all I have to take your heart away.
These are the Hobo Chronicles. Interviews conducted with hobos over the course of a day at the Cameo Motel, 4111 82nd Avenue, Portland, Oregon, room 27, August 23, 2018. Interviewers Simon Raffi, Jeremy Glad, with screener Patricia Parks. 9 a.m., hobo number one, Gino, age 42 years, living as a hobo 12 years. It's not hard to figure out why I took the road. By the time I was 14, I wanted out of the house. Dead in parents, drinking, fighting, I'd had enough. I worked into it gradually. I'd sneak out at night after the parents went to sleep, lower rope down out of the second story window and head down to the amusement park called the Pike. They closed about 3:30 a.m. I'd just walk around talking to people. Started to see that there was a group of people like me that hung out down there. Most of them were druggies and bikers. Some of them were carnies. It was from the carnies that I learned how to live the life on the road. Met a guy who ran the Hammer, one of the most popular rides at the Pike. After hours, we'd share a pint and talk. He would tell me of his travels across the country, first following the circus and finally ended up with an amusement park. He learned how to spot trains, how to work people at a bus stop, how to go to churches on Sunday morning and play the pitiful to get them to give you food and clothing. Yeah, Mel was a good guy. But he died last year, overdose of meth. I still miss him, though. After Mel, I met a guy named Candy. Called him Candy because he worked with the food vendors at the amusement park. He sold cotton candy and taffy and candied apples and such. Now, he made it from Georgia. Worked his way cross country two or three times. His angle was hitchhiking, sifting the goods from Goodwill stores and then reselling it. There's real money in that. People always want somebody else's junk. Once Candy took me on a three-day road trip, heading up Highway 1 toward the northwest. He showed me how you could get a ride if you looked innocent enough. The right clothes, hair, body posture. Get people to pick you up and give you a ride. You know, what to say, what not to say when you're in the car, how to gain acceptance from them, what corners to stand on when you're totally out of money. He had a classic sign that worked every time. I kid you not, car after car would give him dollar bills, fives, tens. You know what his sign read? I need money to get my pet out of the pound. People love pets. He taught me how to play on people's emotions, how to hit them in that place that stirs the heart. You could make it just fine going up Highway 1, along the beach, during the warmer months, never have to work a day. There were some lean times, ketchup packs, crackers, top ramen, but overall, the trip was fun, and I learned a lot. Most important thing I came to understand was that people in America are generous to a fault. When they see a lost cause, they want to feel good about themselves. They don't really care about helping you. It's that feeling of helping someone else that causes them to pop over and over again. 4 months ago, Cotton decided to go back to Georgia and hang out with his family, or what was left of it. I could tell he was worn out from the road, traveling, sleeping under park benches, using cardboard for insulation during the colder months. Takes a toll. Finally took its toll on Cotton. I was sad to see him go. Between those two guys, I learned how to take care of myself. So I decided one day I was going to head out on my own. Cotton always told me head to the warmer states. So I had a bright idea. I decided I'd take a train and work a fair they were having in Phoenix. Maybe get in good with some golfers and become a caddy. time for me to spread my wings. So I'm making my way to Phoenix by train. You know, it's faster and easier, less people. But the people you do encounter can be rough birds. Some of these guys will kill you for a can of tuna or the shoes you're wearing. So you gotta be smart. When you dive onto a car, that's what we call it, diving. When you dive onto a car, make sure you're ready to dive right off again. I did my research. I learned where the hobo camps were along the way. It's important to know where the hobo camps are so you can bail off the train, cop yourself a quick meal, maybe a little rest. When you're in the ring, that's what we call it, the ring, you're among others. They're like you. It's amazing how these guys and gals will share what they've got. If they think you're in the game with them, you're all right. But if you're not, if you're a poser, you might get knifed in your sleep. And believe me, they don't need a knife. They'll use the lid of a tuna can to slit your throat. Whatever's handy in the jungle.
Smile, an everlasting smile. A smile can bring you near to me.